Hello and welcome to the Film Room, where today we're talking about the Mavs' comeback win against the Orlando Magic when they turned a 15-point first-half deficit into a 15-point win. In many ways, it was a microcosm of the season at this point, Dallas saving a sloppy defensive start by making an impressive turnaround after the break. But what changed? Let's find out. Bit of a spoiler alert here, but it almost all came down to hustle plays and the little details. The Mavs began limiting the Magic's shots inside the lane and at the rim and did a much better job controlling the glass, and that helped flip the game. Now, it's one thing to tell you, but it's another thing to show you. Brace yourselves. Some of these first few clips might be a little uncomfortable. Let's go to the footage. Defense is all about communication, which is especially important when playing against a team like Orlando that cuts back door. Are we switching or not? And with all eyes on the ball and none on Franz Wagner, that momentary confusion results in an easy layup. The Magic started hot from three, so the Mavs eventually switched to a 2-3 zone for a few possessions, but with similar luck against those cutters. The communication was better here, but the result was the same. It wasn't just backdoor cuts either. Orlando was cutting with success from every direction against both man and zone. Here, Paolo Banchero just flashes to the middle of the floor and no one is there, and it's an easy shot. The Magic assisted on 20 of their 26 made field goals in the first half, scoring 34 points in the paint. Ouch. It wasn't all on cuts, though. Here, Orlando creates some confusion with Joe Ingles as a decoy to set up a middle pick and roll with Cole Anthony and Mo Wagner. Anthony turns the corner freely as Tim Hardaway Jr. ices the screen and Dwight Powell drops to contain the drive, but neither Derrick Jones Jr. nor Kyrie Irving tag the rolling Wagner, so Anthony could just make an easy drop-off for the layup. Most dispiritingly, Orlando also won a lot of 50-50 balls. Here, Jalen Suggs attacks early off a made shot, then retrieves his own rebound, then saves it in, then gets a wide-open corner three, and it doesn't stop there. Powell commits a loose ball foul to give the Magic yet another second chance, which they would then convert. Orlando scores more than 18 second chance points per game, which led the NBA going into Monday night's contest. In order to beat hard-playing teams, you've got to play really hard too. Starting in the second half, the Mavs did just that. The Mavs watched a few too many easy backdoor cuts go for layups in the first half and eventually said, no more. Here, Luka Doncic overplays Franz Wagner in the corner, expecting him to come get the ball from his brother Mo. He instead cuts backdoor, but right into Kyrie Irving, who pokes the ball loose, then recovers it and draws a foul. Kyrie finished the game with three steals. The Mavs did more dirty work down low, too. Here, Banchero gets to the middle of the floor again, but this time both Kyrie and Hardaway tag the rolling Goga Bitadze, eliminating the lob threat and instead forcing a pass out to the corner. But Hardaway's job isn't finished there. He stays with the play and is able to swat Suggs' pass away, and Derek Lively recovers it. Dallas forced a season-high 21 turnovers against Orlando, with 9 of them going for steals, their second most in a game this season. There was also a lot of impressive individual effort. Derek Jones Jr. switches on to Anthony here and completely erases his drive. Jones ends up getting inadvertently poked in the eye fighting for a loose ball, but stays with it, and on the ensuing play keeps his hands high to prevent a pass to Wagner, then finishes the play by boxing the big man out and allowing Kyrie to gather the rebound. Nice defense by Powell on Banchero too, to keep him further from the basket. Here, Grant Williams navigates traffic at the top of the key and cuts off Banchero, then does the same after switching on Anthony. Hardaway does a great job recognizing Anthony Black's backdoor cut, leaving Mo Wagner in a really uncomfortable spot late in the shot clock. The Mavs' defensive rating is nearly 20 points better in the second half than in the first half. Dallas has done a great job making tactical adjustments at halftime in most of these games, but a lot of their improvement simply just comes from making more hustle plays. In between Kyrie and Luka's game-sealing threes was this possession, a culmination of all the principles we've already discussed. Banchero attacks early in the clock, but Williams is already in position and gets help from Powell, who does a great job staying vertical. Together they force a miss, then Kyrie comes away with the 50-50 ball and pushes it up the floor before finding Luka for the dagger. We know the Mavs' offense is good, but their defense is also helping them create even more points.
Kyrie Irving has lifted the Dallas lead to 11, and once again Dallas' defense crams the door shut on Banchero, and a dagger! First Kyrie, then Luka. And they are starting to get up and head for the exits.
The Mavs knew they needed to improve their defense from last season, and adding Grant Williams, Derek Lively, and Derek Jones Jr., among others, should help them do just that. But everyone's got to buy in, and we've seen that so far. it was not pretty in the first half, but it was pretty good in the second half. Sometimes great defense is about forcing tough shots, but other times it's just about flat-out effort. The Mavs have cranked that up in a big way in many of their wins this season. Here's to hoping that moving forward, we'll see a lot more of that in the first half too. Thank you for watching The Film Room. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like. I would really, really appreciate it. What do you think is the biggest reason behind the Mavs' 6-1 start? Is it good defense like this, or is it something else? Drop a comment below and let us know. Till next time, I'm Bobby Karalla. You are awesome, and we'll see you later.